Hello everyone, welcome back to Minecraft. If you're wondering why I'm here, our safe house kind of caved in on us. So we're kind of stuck. Ooh. Luckily I carried an iron shovel. I dug out my bed. You can mine that out. Don't need to hold on to that. I actually don't mind keeping the that, so we can get rid of the snow. Work towards the exit. This way, because there, here's a dirt pattern that says no. What happened was, is I took my crafting table out of the thing, and I forgot just above it was sand. And when I took it out, it lost its kind of support. So it caused the entire cave to cave in. And you should have seen Beckaboo's face, like, like, oh my gosh, like the whole world is just freaking just stopped and hurt in their world tracks. And I was a bit kind of worried about that. Oh. We don't got time to stay here. I guess whoever comes back here again will have to do all the fixings and fix that up. Right now, we gotta make sure. Ah, you son of a effer. We're not fixing any dang roof. We'll fix it. Okay. At least we'll find our cave again. It's right here. Pretty cool looking cave. I liked it. But these are the mysteries of the desert. You gotta be careful. Very dangerous. Very, very dangerous. Good point. I almost forgot. Okay, everybody. We're retracing our steps a little bit just to get all the parts rediscovered. So we can get this area mapped out. I got 3 cactus, that's good enough. We gotta make sure we keep the cactus. That's gonna be very useful. Silly rabbits. Tricks are for kids. Hey, they are. Okay, we got it mapped out. Now we're going to continue our journey. I'm going to run my butt off and try to get there. I'll do a transition here, so the next interesting thing that happens, you guys ain't sitting here watching me travel for a long distance of time. Okay, we found some type of structure out here. We're going to go and investigate. Why is there one single block missing? Huh. What is this thing? It's some sort of well. Made out of sandstone. In the middle of nowhere. Huh. Well, I wonder what that's for. I was gonna happen since we saw that was gonna be something close to a village. That's why I'm trying to be thorough with this investigation right now of this area, because there could be a village in the sand, or sand people. There's another pumpkin. The one thing we still haven't found yet either is watermelons. Watermelons would be something interesting to have. So far, we have yet to run into any rare spawns. Except for an invisible spider, which attacked me back at my house, which was kind of weird. This is all stones. We're going to go back to the desert and keep going and progressing through that way. There's a little bit of mountains in the front of it, of this desert. I'm running out of food. Yeah, getting there. Let's try to see if we can't rush down here real fast and get a space made. If I'm right, deserts hold a more increase in spawns as well. So being out in desert would be like playing Killing Floor and playing it on hard with everything coming at you at once. So we have to settle down somewhere. Yeah, we're gonna have to. I know, cause it's gonna drop. Okay, that's a good idea. Becca Boo for the ideas, everybody. So let's try this. Doesn't have to be too fancy, just as long as we can build a thing and we can use dirt to fill it out. For the roof. The bunny scared me for a moment there. Huh? I know. Unfortunately, I do not have enough supplies to block the roof. I do not. This is not good. There we go. Through a door. As long as we can tell when it's daytime. I'll see you guys when it's morning. Okay, everybody, welcome back. We have finished our night here making a base. We're gonna leave this place in case Becca Boo goes wandering around at night. I did. See how it looks for me outside. It almost looks camouflaged. So let's get to the map again and get a move on to the next location. Seems like it grows similar to sugarcane. I think it does only grow in sand. The only thing I noticed that's different is that it doesn't have to be next to water. Compared to the sugar cane. I hope they come up with more critters to throw in the water. Because to me, it's kind of annoying to, just to see octopuses all the time. Sharks or something. I mean, something else would be nice to be thrown in there. They had 20 new mobs for the surface just to randomly spawn rares. But keep an eye out for a temple, at the very least a village. That's what I would like to find right now, is a village. Down this way because we got a whole bunch of stuff to cover on this corner. More sticks. Sorry everyone, I didn't mean to be all quiet. Just that it's anticipation waiting. You never know when the village may come into sight. So I'll cut the video here for a second until we run into something interesting. Okay everybody, we're back. We got something in front of our sights and it looks like a temple. And it feels like it. It looks like it. It has like the... And there might be a village. Woohoo, we hit the jackpot, everybody. Villagers finally. Now we know where the zombies are coming from.
Don't die.
If I remember correctly about this temple, at the bottom there is C4 landing. But there is a trick to get around it. Very simple trick, if it's the same way as I remember. First things first, we enter it from the normal way. See, these are wool. This is all wool. Should be anyway. Now down below is where the thing is. We need to go straight down. But be careful because there is a pleasure crate. Oh no. Destroy it. That should stop the TNT from blowing up. We got tons of sandstone we don't need. And some weird looking sandstone. A gold apple. Another saddle. Some gunpowder. Gold bars. More gunpowder. Enchantment of Smite 5. That's the strongest enchantment you could have for killing undead.
Dude, I want that.
And you put that, and we got a diamond sword that's unenchanted at home right now.
This is my sword.
This could make the most holy sword there could possibly be.
Yeah, it was an emerald too.
And one little emerald, which we have yet to see before. Keep. We'll take the emerald. We can trade out, I think, this, because I think, yeah, it's just apposite. We don't care about that. Why don't you string? I would like to take that with me, because that's useful.
If it was just a rabbit meat, real quick,
so let's take the... String. Yeah, we got gunpowder on us from killing a creeper earlier. We got some gold bars here. We can put the wool back. I don't think we're going to find any wolves, so we're not going to worry about the friends. We got two gold apples now. We do need the saddle because of extra horse, because when Beck Boo gets here, we only got one saddle, so we need two saddles for both of us, at least one horse. Nope. So, we can do the pumpkin seeds here. We got tons of them at home. We don't have to worry about that. Take the gunpowder. Take the string, because that'll be useful. More gunpowder. Some more string. Another golden apple. I think right underneath here is TNT. That's all TNT, baby. This is not time to have any kind of fire near these bastards. They will extremely blow up. We need to toss the chicken. Toss that. We got the TNT good. Take all the TNT, so that way there's no chance of that blowing up on us. We should probably take a chest with us, huh? Mm-hmm. That's what I'm thinking about, but we get plenty of wood, we can just make a chest. And obviously this is red wool and blue wool and everything else. Yep. Yep, looks like we're bunking for the night in the temple. Gonna have to be a safe house for tonight. Doors in front of these. There we go. Lay down a bed. Get our smelter. Crafting table. Technically, we could actually use this as a forward base command. I didn't have my map of it again, so we didn't explore it. So, everybody, we had, at least we know the general area where it's at now.
Damn dit.
But at least we got it done. Okay, do we need to smelt anything or cook anything? The only thing I can see in here that's worth cooking is just the raw mutton, in case our food supply gets low. And we did open quite a few slots, so we can probably take some extra stuff if you want. What, you want the blue wool? Okay.
Good job.
I guess we gotta dig back down again. Okay. This is the time when Becca kind of tends to call me names. I mean, names that I think I deserve to be called right now because I'm kind of being an idiot. At least we got four chests here. That can make two full chests. Mm-hmm. We might actually leave the bed here, I'm thinking. Just use it as a forward command. I don't know. I'm just trying to gather bits by bits because you never know what happens. This is orange hardened clay.
Awesome.
So to me, that means clay can be dyed, which is interesting. Blue hardened clay. So that's not even what we originally thought it was. A couple more mutton. Some more charcoal. We'll leave the bed here and torches in an attempt to try to, if we die, at least we'll be nearby. I'd like to try to dig these out and try to throw some glass in here. Sorry guys, I know you want to get exploring and doing some stuff here. I'm just trying to investigate stuff right now. Ah, more orange hardened clay. All through there. And we got a village, everybody. We got a village. I picked up more sandstone by accident. Trying to think of anything else to be. I know that there was a lot of open spots earlier. It's probably because of the clay. But we got one extra spot, so if we get something new up here that we haven't seen before. Let's see. Aha! Potatoes! Potatoes! We won't ruin them all because in case I die. Villagers are talking. They're pumpkin monster villagers. Emerald, one emerald for 16 coal. Five emeralds for an iron shovel with efficiency 2. It's just in her eyebrows. It just shot up as soon as you saw that. Like, whoa, that's something new. An iron helmet. No worry, guys. I'm not gonna kill yuns. You guys are like a rare commodity. Hey, donkeys. Iron helmet. Pumpkin monsters. I can't talk to you apparently. Ah! Hey, donkey. Zombie flesh. Yep. Donkeys. Is it a donkey?
Yeah. Ears.
Yep. Donkey hee-haw. Donkeys. That's something new, everybody. Way in the corner. Just next to a village. Whoa! Everybody, we hit the jackpot of villages. Actually, if I remember correctly, if we were to find a village, that's where your plain lands would be for horses. I think you can put saddles on donkeys. Run.
Yeah.
Into another village. An iron helmet. Another iron helmet. I think they got a lava leak over there going on. Everybody, we see our one thing we're looking for. And ironically, I got a saddle. So I see myself riding a horse for the rest of my travels, and we're gonna head straight home with the horse. I see some easy mapping going on. I'm gonna go this dark horse right here, brown darkish horse. Unfortunately, I think it takes a vegetable of some kind. Could try doing that. Hey, I need to clean my hand out though. Let's see. Oh, sandstone. Whoa. Mounting. Now that I got that done, we put the saddle on. Our mapping has just gotten easier. Right on, horse. Woohoo! I think even if the horse dies, I think you actually get the saddle back. Whoa. Apparently, if you hit the water too hard, too, you get splashed right off. We're gonna cover some huge amount of speed, I think. At least now we know where your plane lands is. Up in that corner up there. I knew it, I had a feeling, because if you remember last, or when we played on console, the guys or villagers were actually near one of your flatlands. Like the villagers always put their place down in the flatland. So if we find a village, we'd find your horses. We're at end of video here, guys, and I'll see you guys in the next video.
Bye.
Thank you guys for watching the series. This is a little bonus clip at the end. And I'm here to just tell you guys this is what the map looked like after I got back home. Things are looking really well. And my haunted, scary Halloween adventure here is turning out pretty well. We discovered an actual desert. And up in here in this top corner, I finally have healed some horses. And there's also villages and stuff here. Now we discovered all that. We know all over here is all mountains. We know all here is nothing but forest. Thick forest. And there is something troubling me with the dark oak trees down here. I'm wondering what secrets are they hiding. But you can see this panel's missing right here, so we haven't explored over here, we haven't explored over here, here, or here, down here. There's still about a few more panels, but weren't there? There could be an actual additional panel over here. And over here. Or over here. So that will make a very, very, very large map. So we're eventually have to start expanding this place and making a mapping room. And if we do expand it, we might push this back farther and get more bookshelves going on this thing. We got the Enchant Smite 5 on the Diamond Sword. Becca Blue should be hopefully be playing this game by, I would say by tomorrow, which today is Friday, she'll be here on Saturday. So Saturday the 9th, Becca Boo should be in the game and helping me out in my adventures. So we'll probably see her. Hopefully she'll have a mic as well. I got a mic for her to wear. So we'll have her with me in this little adventure of ours. We created a leash. Got everything put down and everything. We got an iron armored horse. She wanted diamond armor, so I'm gonna give her the diamond armor. We got our defensive perimeter set up. The iron golem is still protecting our base. A horse, and I got some hay bale for the horse. These pumpkins are turning into troops. The snow is additional troops for our for the ranged attackers. We are set and ready to go for our defensive position. But thanks for watching, guys. I hope you're enjoying the series, and I'll see you next time. Bye!